Daily Evening Prayer, Saturday, May 4th, 2024. Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for the sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all sins, and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the world. My God, why have you forsaken me, and are so far from my cry and from the words of my complaint? O my God, I cry in the daytime, but you do not hear, in the night season also, but I find no rest. But you remain holy, enthroned upon the praises of Israel. Our fathers hoped in you, they trusted in you, and you delivered them. They called upon you and were delivered. They put their trust in you and were not confounded. But as for me, I am a worm and no man, scorned by all and the outcast of the people. All those who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips and shake their heads, saying, "He trusted in God that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him if he will have him." But you are he that took me out of my mother's womb. You were my hope when I was yet upon my mother's breasts. I have been cast upon you ever since I was born. You are my God, even from my mother's womb. O God, not far from me, for trouble is near at hand, and there is none to help me. Many oxen have come around me, and fat bulls of Bashan close me in on every side. They gape at me with their mouths, like a ravening and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water, and all the bones are out of joint. My heart also, in the midst of my body, is like melting wax. My strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue cleaves to my gums. And you bring me into the dust of death. For many dogs have come about me, and the counsel of the wicked lays siege against me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. They stand staring and looking at me. They part my garments among them and cast lots for my clothing. But be not far from me, O Lord. You are my succor. Hasten to help me. Help me. Deliver my soul from the sword, my life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth and my soul in misery from among the horns of wild oxen. I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. O praise the Lord, you that fear him. Magnify him, all you seed of Jacob. And fear him, all you seed of Israel. For he has not despise, nor abhorred the low estate of the poor. He has not hidden his face from him, but when he called upon him, he heard him. My praise is of you in the great congregation. My vows will I perform in the sight of those who fear him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek after the Lord shall praise him. May your hearts live forever. At the ends of the world, all the ends of the world shall remember and be turned unto the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall worship before him. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he is the governor among the peoples. All those who sleep in the earth, how shall they worship him? All those who go down into the dust, how shall they kneel before him? But my life shall be preserved in his sight, and my children shall worship him. They shall tell of the Lord to the generations to come, and to a people yet unborn shall they declare his righteousness, that he has brought it to pass. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore I lack nothing. He shall feed me in green pastures and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort. He shall refresh my soul and bring me forth in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, and your rod and your staff comfort me. You shall prepare a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Job, beginning with the 32nd chapter, the first verse. Then these three men stopped answering Job because he was righteous in his own eyes. But the anger of Elihu, the son of Baricho, the Buzite, of the family of Ram, burned against Job. His anger burned because he justified himself before God, and his anger burned against his three friends because they had found no answer, yet they had condemned Job. Now Elihu had waited to speak to Job because they were years older than he, but when Elihu saw that there was no answer in the mouth of these three men, his anger burned. So Elihu, the son of Barachel, the Buzite, spoke out and said, I am young in years and you are old, therefore I was shy and afraid to tell you what I think. I thought age would speak, and increased years would teach wisdom, but it is a spirit that is in mankind, and the breath of the Almighty gives me understanding. The abundant in years may not be wise, nor may elders understand justice. So I say, listen to me, I too will tell you what I think. Behold, I waited for your words, I listened to your skillful speech. While you pondered what to say, I also paid close attention to you. But indeed, there was no one who refuted Job, not one of you who answered his words. So do not say, we have found wisdom. God will defeat him, not man. But he was not presented with, but he has not presented his words against me, nor will I reply to him with your arguments. They are dismayed, they no longer answer. Words have failed them. Should I wait because they are not speaking, because they have stopped and no longer answer? I too will give my share of answers. I also will tell my opinions, for I am full of words. The spirit within me compels me. Behold, my belly is like unvented wine, like new wineskins. It is about to burst. Let me speak so that I may get relief. Let me open my lips and answer. Let me be partial to no one, nor flatter any man, for I do not know how to flatter. Otherwise, my maker would quickly take me away. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid, for the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore, you shall draw water with rejoice. Therefore, you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day, you shall say, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. A reading from the first epistle of St. Peter, beginning with the first chapter, the 22nd verse. Since you have purified your souls in obedience to the truth for a sincere love of the brothers and sisters, fervently love one another from the heart, for you have been born again not of seed which is perishable, but imperishable, that is, through the living and enduring word of God. For all flesh is like grass, and all its glory is like the flower of grass. The grass withers and the flowers fall off, but the word of the Lord endures forever. And this is the word which was preached to you. Therefore, rid yourselves of all malice and all deceit and hypocrisy and envy and all slander, and like newborn babies, long for the pure milk of the word, so that by it you may grow in respect to salvation, if you have tasted the kindness of the Lord. In coming to him as to a living stone which has been rejected by people, but is choice and precious in the sight of God, you also, as living stones, are being built up as a spiritual house for a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices that are acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For this is contained in Scripture. Behold, I am laying in Zion a choice stone, a precious cornerstone, and the one who believes in him will not be put to shame. This precious value, then, is for you who believe. This precious value, then, is it for you who believe? But for unbelievers, is for you who believe. But for unbelievers, a stone which the builders rejected, this became the chief cornerstone, and a stone of stumbling, and a rock of offense. For they stumble because they are disobedient to the word, and to this they were also appointed. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for God's own possession, so that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. For you once were not a people, but now you are the people of God. You had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels meet us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love toward you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of eternal light, shed forth your unending day upon us, who watch for you, that our lips may praise you, our lives may bless you, and our worship on the morrow may give you glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another your abounding grace may increase among us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy sons, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to all, to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Alleluia, Alleluia. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.